Water is New Mexico's most precious resource, and that resource is running thin as the drought continues. But overnight, vandals wasted thousands and thousands of gallons of water, and it appears whoever did this knew a few things about irrigation. News 13's Gabrielle Burkhart explains.
Much of the water has gone down since this morning, but earlier today, a lot of this area was underwater. Parks and Rec officials say someone opened an irrigation valve overnight.
Caution tape still blocks off part of the flood zone, the scene of a rare sight. An abundance of water flooding the Bukkake open space. At this point, it's not known how much water was wasted, but county officials say it's at least in the thousands of gallons.
The pond could only hold so much water before it, the water went over its banks and really extended into the areas where water shouldn't be.
The only ones happy about it are the geese. The overnight flood is blamed on vandalism.
When someone violates the respect of this ground, we're passionate about it and we're upset.
County Parks and Rec Director Ed Chismar says someone had to have come in after hours, taken off the lock to this irrigation valve, then closed this valve to trap the water. The result was a massive flood, wasting huge amounts of water people use for agriculture.
This vandalism, you know, deprived people that have crops, you know, the use of this, the beneficial use of this water.
It's water the area can't afford to lose. Extreme drought conditions and little rain have caused a shortage, so much so that Monday, the Middle Rio Grande Conservancy District announced water bank users will no longer receive deliveries. Damage costs due to the unnecessary flood are estimated at $10,000. But the water loss, officials say, that you can't put a price tag on.
This disrespect for our public places like this is just unacceptable.
Gabrielle Burkhart, KRQE News 13.
The Conservancy District says a blow like this will affect irrigators near the area, but they won't have to curtail their water use just yet. The county is spending about $300,000 each year on vandalism repairs.